I'm Cathy Camper, and I'm a retired librarian. I worked for Multnomah County as a youth outreach librarian for 15 years, but I spent my whole life as a librarian and a writer. I'm half Lebanese and half white. My dad's side of the family is Lebanese. I'm third generation, and my mom's side is white. And I'm really excited about Arab American Heritage Month because I think Arabs aren't always visible in the United States, and there's also a lot of stereotypes. There's millions of Arabs that have lived in the United States for generations, and there's millions of immigrants and refugees that are acclimating and becoming citizens and feel very strongly that we need to recognize how that culture is a part of American culture. I went into librarianship because I thought it's a career that backs up my writing because you learn to find the answer to anything in the known universe, and that's pretty good for a writer. But also it's something I could spend my life helping people. And I'm really excited about connecting this book with Arab Heritage Month because it's called Arab, Arab All Year Long. And it goes through all the months of the year, just sharing things about Arab kids. So showing that Arab culture is ancient, but also very modern. And a lot of this is both so Arab kids in the huge diaspora can see things that they identify with, but also so that all the other cultures can see things that aren't just stereotypes of us. My school friends are busy celebrating winter holidays. Mom lets me have a slumber party instead. My big sister is the best henna artist. All my cousins want her designs. We wrap our hands in gauze and watch horror movies in the dark at our henna party sleepover. The henna dries while we're asleep. The next day, when we rub the dried paste away, delicate designs adorn our palms. One time when I was in Oakland, this little girl followed me the rest of my visit, just like wanting to touch me, like I'm a role model kind of, like she was just staring at me like, you made these books and you're Arab. Like, it's not even just what's in the book, it's that you're standing there and saying, your dream can come true and this is how I did it. Shukran, that means thank you for helping us be seen, but then also, like I said, as a librarian and as an author, that young people coming up will feel more at home here, and that the next generations, it will always get better.